All right, what is up, ladies and gentlemen?
Why don't you
Welcome
just
to
live
the.
stream it?
Yeah.
Because I don't want.
Remember?
To all
I
the
don't
two
want to.
people who care. Come on, please.
Exactly.
They want to watch it in real time.
When the numbers get better, we'll live stream. But hey, guys, welcome to the Please Don't Sarcasm podcast. Today I'm joined by STDX Crypto, STDX
What's
Hydro,
up?
STDX Buddha. Actually, I pointed to it. And then Fabio, which is actually over there. Fabio just got off a 24-hour live stream, so he's kind of tired. But. Thank you all for coming out. Yeah, we were actually talking about, like, it's great that it's for charity, but fuck. Anyways, thank you all for coming out. And today, we're continuing our bouts of BO3. In the center, as you can see, I'll actually be doing the Nuketown Easter egg and then probably some multiplayer other stuff as we talk. Thanks to Hydro for coming up with that idea.
Yeah,
and
bro.
It's like, yeah, that's me. Anyways, so let's start off with Buddha, because you're over there on the screen.
Nice.
What, compared to your expectations, how did BO3 turn out?
All right. This is kind of tough.
Honestly, I thought it turned out a lot better than I thought it would. I thought it'd be like the beta, and then I would fucking trash the game after 2 days. But it's keeping me intrigued with new things. I'm liking it so far. I'm kind of playing Uplink right now. Losing, but I'm playing. I'm gonna lose, actually, the whole game in a second, but... Bro, like, it's pretty good.
Don't you always lose, Hydro?
Bro, that's not true. I won 2 UMGs today.
Yeah, but it's like day, what, 3 of the game being out? So...
Yep.
I mean...
I still hold myself to those standards, man.
There are some pretty big scrubs, Hydro, playing GBs at the moment, thinking their dreams are going to become true.
Yep.
They're trying not to let their dreams be dreams.
I'm going to become fucking Optic Nade Shot, bro. I'm going to be the Nade
Million
Shot.
Dollar player.
Million dollar player.
Okay, I miss everything. Buddha, what about you?
Okay. Well, it's kind of tough because I really suck at the game, but... Expectation-wise, I wanted it to be just like Black Ops 2, and it's kind of same feel, just, you know, with a little boosting kind of thing. The only thing that pisses me the fuck off is kids that sit in the corner with their fucking Tempest and just get fucking, like, 5 kills with that shit, just sitting in the corner charging that shit up. Fucking grinds my gears.
See, I
other than that,
with a war machine.
You know what really grinds my gears? Is
that,
like,
that's not the game's fault. It's just, like... shitty kids play it, so I can't really be mad at
dude,
it.
Okay,
but...
now hold on. I hate the kids that go into fucking arena and ban the quick draw and then ban grip.
Yeah,
what?
Needs to get fixed up. Off my first impressions, because the first game we played in arena, we started off, we banned blast suppressor, we banned the M8A1, we are in A7. We
I
banned
always
ban
the M8.
God, we banned so many, like, stupid things, like, awareness, we banned grenades, we banned...
So basically, you made it into Ground War, or, no, sorry, Mercenary, or what was it, Old School?
Made it extremely stupid, and that's something that I think they need to fix up right off the get-go for Arena, is ban the basic stuff, like UAV, that's something that needs to be banned off the start. All recons need to be banned right off the start. All explosions need to be banned right off the start. And then allow the players to ban certain stuff. And I feel like certain stuff, like the whole save system, there should be a set perks and weapons that are automatically saved that are seen in the pro status. That way you don't have just chaos.
So explain to the viewers what exactly Arena is.
Arena is the competitive mode, kind of like League play. But in this one, they brought in the MOBA aspect of being able to ban and pick items. So when you first start off, you have 4v4. Right now, it's broken as hell. So if someone disconnects, you can go 3v5 or even 2v6. In a competitive.
Dude, I went 2v8 in fucking that.
But
wow.
Speaking with it, so let's say, like, I'm on top of my team. I get to choose first. I can either ban or pick any item in the game. There's no bans at the moment, no, like, saves like I say there should be. But I can ban whatever I want right off the get-go. Let's say I ban Blast Suppressor. Now no one can use Blast Suppressor. And it just rotates back and forth between the 4 players. And then after that, it allows you to have, like, 90 seconds to create a class based off of everything that was banned and secured. And like I said, it's chaos at the moment because there's no real organization to it, and everyone's sitting there going, "Oh, let's be stupid, let's ban Blast Suppressor." Oh, great, yay, no boosting, you know?
Right. So,
or if UAV didn't get banned, people are using recon streaks and in a competitive.
Right. So there. It's, you know, day three. It's still. I need to restart this because I didn't get it in 2 minutes.
It's still got some problems. Still got some bugs like the beta. But
give any it a mechanical bug. Bugs though? I mean.
Yeah. There's like blue screen after you're done with the game. That fucking it just freezes your whole game.
Yeah, we've already froze screen a couple of times. Visco froze twice the other day. There's just a couple issues with that. I do feel like my personal take on the game is I'm having no problem dropping kills. At times I don't feel like it's playing fast enough because I mean Advanced Warfare kind of fucked the entire COD system and made it way too fast.
Can I bring one thing up? Because it just happened to me. And that is the fact that you get hit off the Xbox Live servers on the fucking BO3 and it kicks you out of everything.
Yeah, that's another one. I've seen that a couple times.
I fucking hate it and it just happened to me.
Then going back to the aspects of the game, like, I don't know. I play really, really well on it, but I still feel that whole Call of Duty feel of host is everything. You know, the registration is absolutely everything.
I actually felt like that was pretty equal now. Like, I played every game mode pretty much in the game already, and every type, like, even the competitive a little bit. And I felt like host didn't really matter as much in this game. You could still fucking roast people even though you weren't host. Like, I thought that was pretty good. The host was kind of evened out.
Okay.
I feel like certain guns take too many bullets too at the moment.
There's a couple things like the ICR it just feels weak. Like to me personally, like I love the gun, but it just feels super weak to me.
The Pharaoh is fucking OP as fuck.
I do realize that headshots are absolutely everything in this game because it takes eight body shots, but like 3 headshots. Like
Three. Yeah, it's more like 2. I mean, and it'll get some taking used to because you gotta also think in Advanced Warfare it was fucking 2 shots in the body and they're dead. In this game it's like 7, like Black Ops 2.
Alright ladies though, I'm out. I'm gonna hop over to Mitch's deal. I'm gonna play some competitive, at least give it a try. But thank you, Wolfie, for hosting.
No problem.
Hopefully see you guys later and see everyone else later. Take care though.
Alright, see you
guys. Alright guys. So we're going to have a slight change in things. Hopefully that doesn't screw up everything.
Do you have 5 webcams on your screen?
Yeah.
All right, just change it to 1 webcam in every corner.
Right, I know. I'm just trying to get this Easter egg.
Did you have one just like straight in the center?
Well,
Where's the 5th webcam?
No, they were surrounding the game, like the game.
Oh, playing. You just like put them all at the top or something?
Just surrounding it. So there's like me on top, 2 to my right, and then Buddha and Crypto were on the left and right hand sides.
Oh, I got you.
So it was just kind of like surrounding everything. Trying to do this stupid Easter egg, and it's just not working.
For Nuketown?
Yeah.
You gotta get it under 2 minutes, and you gotta get all the heads. So you might miss a head, or you might, you know. Something. I'm about to play an arena game alone, which is probably a mistake, but we'll. Off the bat, this guy bans War Machine.
there's a gun I really hate. And
ban Sight. I get that. I get that. Ban the... Oh, I just protected the M8. Fuck. I meant to ban it.
There's a gun I really hate. The Haymaker. And if you know how to use that gun... Oh my god. It was destroying things.
No one really uses a Haymaker from what I see.
I was in the game, this guy went like 70 and 10 on hardpoint with the Haymaker. Yep. I kind of quit after that. Buddha, what about you? Anything you want to add to the multiplayer? Or
I didn't really get to play a lot of the arena or at all, because every time I tried to play, it was like, couldn't find a match. So I was really upset about that. But I really like what Crypto is talking about with the picks and bans type of thing, like banning certain things. I think it's going to make, if they bring it into actual esports, like, you know, the competitive side, if they actually use that in tournament stuff, I think that'll be pretty fucking sick. Because it'll be like, it'll have an incentive.
Actually, it is a competitive. But I've played it a little bit already, and with competitive, what they do, I'm sorry, but with competitive, they already have a set of banned stuff, and then when you get into the game, you can pick to ban other shit.
Yeah, but like imagine watching someone's stream and seeing them doing really well with it. Say you're watching Skump or whatever, and he's just wrecking with this one gun. Like, you're going to pick to ban that specific gun to get that out of his hands 100% of the time. You don't want him to have it. So I mean,
it brings a lot of diversity into the game.
Yeah, and it'll make everyone expand their variety of guns. Because like in Advanced Warfare, it was ASM1 and Battle the entire time.
Right. It brings it to where people need to be good with every gun instead of just like one or two guns. They have to be good with any type of combat. So assault rifle, sub, even like... Are you joking me, man?
Even...
It just fucking kicked me out again. I'm done.
100% we're going to see a lot more LMGs. No doubt.
Bruh, ML... I fucking hate those guns. They fucking screw me over. Two shots with a fucking LMG kills you. It's so fucking retarded. Yeah. Well,
just imagine.
That, thanks for telling me. Now I actually know a few weapons I might go and use. I'm just having trouble with mouse and keyboard because it's a lot harder to strafe.
Well, you can set up your... You can get a controller and play on your PC.
The port's fucked. The port is fucked. Not only is the port fucked, but also the, like Fabio said, there's a huge disadvantage if you're using PC, like versus PC controls, because on PC, like everyone is super accurate, like just pinpoint. Yeah. Like you turn a corner, there's a sniper. No matter what, you're getting shot. Like there's rarely moments where you're like both just trying to shoot the other guy. So, but when I used the controller, it felt super, super clunky and unresponsive. And then I was like thinking it was the controller or, you know, the game. And then, you know, we realized it was the port for the controllers. So I was just like, well, damn. And then, so that's why I'm thinking like, fuck, I can't do this.
And this is, that's why a console trumps PC for Call of Duty.
Yeah, I mean, because, well, the reason it trumps is because the tournaments. These tournaments are only on console because to set it up on PC is a lot harder.
Well, not even that. It's just like the COD community isn't really on PC because just not.
CS is a PS FPS. It's the main FPS on PC. But Call of Duty's always been a console game. It really hasn't moved over to CS. PC. Like custom zombies is the only. Well, fuck you, Wolfie. I love CS.
No, I love it too. I love it too. Don't get me wrong. I love that game, but God, it's hard.
I gotta love it.
Of course it's hard.
People are just like fucking ninjas and they're sharpshooters and shit. Like they are trained in the goddamn military to fucking shoot a sniper. That's how they act, man.
I always encounter the guy that's just a fucking don with everything and wandigs me all the time. I just quit. I just sit and spawn.
Bruh, Jukes.
Okay. So the peak for today in Counter-Strike CSGO, 679,000 people played it today. Black Ops 3, 63,000.
Wow. Holy fuck. No way. That's a lie.
Completely believable.
What were the numbers?
Counter-Strike CSGO, 679,000 was its peak, and Black Ops 3's peak is 63,000.
I told you. It's not surprising.
Oh, it's definitely surprising.
No, it's not.
No, yeah, I mean, it's honestly, because it's like, yeah, it's the COD for PC.
Like, it's just I love COD. I used to play on console, but now I don't have a console, so I have to play it on PC, and it's hard to find a game. So I've kept thinking maybe I should just get a console to play COD, but then I just can't bring myself to spend that money.
Yeah, who's going to spend money on a console just for COD? I mean,
me.
Dude, get PS4, man. If you're just gonna use it, if you're just using it for COD, get PS4. But if you're gonna end up using it for more than just COD, then get an Xbox.
Halo 5, guys.
Bro, if you're
hearing a lot of stuff about that.
If you're gonna get Halo, yeah, get Xbox and get the Halo and Black Ops 3. Because trust me, the only plus to having the PS4 is so you get the maps earlier, and that's really the only thing I'd use it for.
And to play competitively, because...
Nope.
Are they still on Xbox? I thought they transitioned all the way.
Nope. No, you can play competitive on Xbox.
Yeah, but I mean, that was like AW. I want to get a PS4 team together, and everyone's like, shut the fuck up. Everyone's on Xbox. Now it's reversed.
You do realize you can still play competitive on Xbox, right?
Yeah, you could pay competitive on PS4 too, but no one's getting paid for it.
Yeah. You can play wagers still on Xbox.
Wait, how does it work now? Because with the UMG events and all that, it's still Xbox.
No, it's all going to be PS4.
Live events are going to be PS4, so if you're going to fly out to an event, you might as well start practicing with a PS4. Mm-hmm. But yeah, for strictly online players, it's better just to stick with the Xbox and play through it.
I wouldn't say it's better, but I mean, it doesn't really make a difference.
Wii. That would be amazing.
The Wii U.
Wii, though, bam, 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 bam. I remember playing World at War on the Wii. It was fucking insane.
How'd that turn out?
Dude, it actually wasn't that bad, if you think.
Shut up, it sucked.
It really wasn't that bad, honestly. I mean, fucking campaign was alright on it.
If you had your sensor off, dude, your shot was all shaky. It sucked. It was awful. Wii is good for Just Dance and Wii Sports. That's it.
Makes sense.
And Mario Kart.
Mario Kart's the shit. I don't care what anyone says. That is the shit right there. That's probably the only game I'd fucking play on Wii. Mario Kart.
I don't know why I'm playing TDM. Just like, I can't find a game for anything else. Like, the only other game mode, like, you can find a game for Domination, Hardpoint. The Nuketown, like, thing that they did in Black Ops 2. TDM and Free For All. Like, if you try to play anything else, like S&D or thing,
Search and Destroy is non-existent.
Yeah, it just does not exist anymore. Which really sucks.
I'm surprised S&D doesn't.
I feel like it'd be a better experience on the PC. It's just the trouble is finding the experience because no one's on it.
Yeah, so you have to get like friends together. I mean, that's really kind of where like the zombies and thrives, because there's everyone who's playing PC is playing zombies.
That's true.
Of course. Zombies is actually very good on PC.
It is sexy. It is beautiful. There's no enemy team. What the fuck?
I just got fucking gravity spiked. I'm done.
Quit.
Bruh.
There's nobody on this. There he is. And I got my. That was my kill, you son of a bitch.
Have you played the zombies yet on BO3?
I haven't played Giant
yet.
Dude,
I got round 32 like on the Giant. It's pretty good.
It's stuck with the old fashioned kind of thing.
Yeah,
I still think they're getting a little too creative with it, like trying to do too many Easter egg type of stuff, but it was still fun.
I think, like, the problem with some of the maps have been, like you had to do the Easter egg in order to do good.
Yeah.
Like, you know,
it's
but
not like a side mission anymore.
That's the thing that they didn't do with this one. It's like, you have the option. You can do it, or you could just chill and get completely destroyed because your aim is off, you know, and just use whatever weapons you have, and now you can customize your weapons, and it's just so cool because like
I
now,
love that.
Yeah, like I have, you know, a red dot sight. What the fuck?
Yeah,
I only have one issue with zombies, and it's you can't restart a game; you have to wait through the cutscene.
Yeah, that is
every.
Really I don't
care
time. About that. I feel
I
like
do.
That's cool.
But it's all I see is just so trees.
Annoying. Fucking like, horrible.
Bruh, it brings the suspense, man.
No, it just makes me think about how bad I did before.
Yeah, I know, right?
Makes me think I have to wait another minute to play the game.
And now I have to watch trees in the meantime. Or whatever. Yeah. Like, at the ending, that's the thing. It's like, okay, we died. We're around, you know, we're this low round. We need to...
Round three
or some shit. Or some
I made it to 32 on the Giant. It's so easy.
Shadows of Evil's in, like, another demon. That map is just so full of content, it's ridiculous. Like, I haven't even...
What was the map that we played today, Hydra? The one with that big-ass serpent turd-looking
Shadows of Evil.
Yeah, dude. We played Shadows.
That thing scares the shit out of me.
Yeah.
Why is there...
It's cute.
You're talking about the one where you start and you can fucking become the beast.
Yeah, that's Shadows of Evil.
Yeah. Bro, I love like being the beast because it, when you go up to the chick and you go to hit LT, it looks like you're smacking her ass. Like, it legit looks like you're smacking her ass.
Slap that ass.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, smack that ass. That's gonna be looking like a fucking vine right there. Like, smack that ass.
Boom.
Fucking Hydro.
Leave it to Hydro to think of that.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. Bro, it's gonna happen.
Sorry, I just mellied the shit out of somebody. And then there's something like for the old school zombie players out there. You know what I'm talking. They brought back Dead Ops Arcade.
Yeah, Dead Ops Arcade 2.
And it is fucking awesome.
Haven't played it yet.
I want to play it. Don't you have to beat the campaign to get it?
You have to beat the first two missions. That's it.
Alright, I'm going to do that tonight.
Wait, what?
You have to beat the first two missions in order to, to get Dead Ops.
I beat it, though.
Yeah, no, you have to beat the campaign in order to get, that was the worst Hellstrike missile ever. In order to get the new zombie campaign, Nightmares. But you don't have to, you just have to beat the first two in order to get the, thingamajig. Dead Ops Arcade.
Well, if we did a co-op on the first three missions, why the hell don't I have it?
You have to, okay, it's like an Easter egg. So, what you have to do is you have to go into the, what's it called? The, like, prep room? Like, where you, before you start a mission, you customize your class. You know that room.
Yeah.
Go to the, like, one of the consoles, I think it's, like, where you just view your stats and stuff. Go to that, and then click on the top left-hand corner, that's the symbol of the Coalescence emblem. Click on that, and then you type in DOA. It'll show you the Dead Ops Arcade's logo, and then just click on DOA, or type in DOA, and then that's it, and it activates it. But you have to do that every time. So it's like a little Easter egg in order to activate it.
Dude, I'm about to go to the campaign right now.
It's actually pretty fun. I was playing it today.
Campaign or Dead Ops?
No, the campaign.
Yeah, I like campaign at first was really it was like slow and annoying, but then after I was just like, wow, this is actually a lot of fun. And then like the last couple of missions, I was like, holy fuck! Like, what the hell?
I've always been like a campaign kid, like playing Halo. I played the Halo campaigns like back and forth 800 times each, you know. But like Call of Duty campaigns are never the best. I don't know. I didn't really like it, but this one's pretty good.
And I'm excited to play the Nightmare campaign. I haven't played it yet because I want to do it on stream, but I was just like, oh, Nightmares. It's like zombies, and then it adds more to the zombie lore, and I'm just like,
wait, do you have Nightmare?
Yeah, I've got it, because I beat the campaign the other night.
I'm going to beat it right now. Fuck it.
Right now?
What mission are you on?
This moment.
First one.
6 or 7 hours, I think.
Play it on realistic.
It's
going to
be a long podcast.
Yeah, I mean, it depends on what difficulty, but I was playing on veteran. Let's see, I went 11-8. Amazing.
Played the first mission on realistic. Restarted that shit. Did it so fucking hard.
I was thinking about it, like, playing through the missions, you really need 4 people to do it on realistic. Like,
oh, yeah.
If you solo it, you've got to, like, know exactly what you're doing.
It'll be a god.
Because it's just, like, there's some missions where there is no cover whatsoever.
Yeah, and there's just like 800 people.
Bro, I really have to watch this intro? It's so boring.
All of it, dude.
All of it.
Bro, how long is it?
Just wait till that robot breaks off those dudes' hands. Ooh.
Spoiler alert.
Why the fuck aren't you able to shoot for like the first 5 minutes of the campaign?
Yeah, I was pissed about that. I was like, why am I walking around?
That ruined it for me. That's the legit reason I don't like the campaign. That's it.
See, he doesn't give it the
right.
That's stupid. Just because you can't shoot for 5 minutes?
No, yeah, okay, so if something... Okay, story-wise, it's stupid. You can't make something boring in the beginning of a game. You're going to get someone to go away from it. That's what I'm doing. Story-wise, they already fucked up the entire thing. I don't care how good the ending is. That's how it is.
Bobby was just like, no.
You can't just like...
I don't give a fuck how good the campaign is. If the beginning can't capture me, fuck it.
I guess.
This guy.
I mean, I don't know. I just wanted to finish it, but
I'm only gonna finish it for the zombies campaign.
I mean,
there was no hook to it at all. I wasn't like intrigued when that first mission was done. I was like, oh, that's cool.
It just later on, it's just there's some parts in it where they make it seem like just a normal Black Ops game, but in the end, you're like, what the fuck? Especially when they tie it in with zombies. They tied in tied in the game with the zombie lore. Like, I'm not even kidding. They tied in the game with the zombie lore. And I'm just like, campaign has never been part of zombies, but then all of a sudden, Black Ops 3 is like, oh, we're gonna mix them all together. And I'm like, what the fuck?
It's like a Harry Potter book. You just gotta push through, keep going, and then it'll get
so
interesting.
Confused.
But yeah, so for the viewers, this is how you activate Dead Ops. So you go here to the data vault. and go to right there, click on that, DOA, and that is Dead Ops Arcade. There's like a lot of Easter eggs in the game. I'm still waiting for someone to find the ray gun and get paid.
Is that a thing?
Well, it was a World at War, and since they're bringing back basically everything they ever had, like, I'm just waiting for it.
I love the ray gun now. They made it like the old ray gun where it's so inaccurate and shit, and it's widespread.
The splash damage and everything.
Splash damage has always been a thing.
Yeah, but it wasn't like a major part.
This is like widespread. This is like wide. So like it goes. I don't know how to explain.
I mean, I've yet to get it, but there's like.
I got it. The first time I hit box.
Bruh, I can shoot that in the first mission. What are you talking about?
No, you can, but it's just like you gotta wait for so fucking long.
I just shot. What are you talking about?
Well, anyway, now I'm excited for the DLC maps. Like, considering Shadows of Evil and the Giant are just so good. Like, what are they bringing? Like, what could they possibly be bringing in DLC? And then I realized PS4 gets it first. I just realized that, and I'm like, fuck! I really need to get myself a PS4. So, God. And what I like about Dead Ops, there's a lot of things they brought from what I like in Zombies, there's a lot of things they brought from custom zombies into, like, Black Ops 3 Zombies. For example, Dead Ops Arcade, you can go into first-person, mode. That was a custom zombie maps was Dead Ops Arcade, but first-person. And I'm lagging my tits off. And then there's, like, the little gumballs, there's perks, like, that they do that actually were created in custom zombies. So, like, Widow's Wine, when a zombie touches you, something happens to the zombie. There was a perk called Scorch in the map Pirate Ship. So what they did is instead of it exploding, it wraps them up in spider webs. Scorch, they would just explode when they touch you. So there's a lot of things that they looked at and like, wow, they actually pay attention to the community. It's so awesome. There's one thing I wanted to figure out is what is it about the new zombies that just feels so different. I don't quite know what it is. Because I know, like, you take more damage.
Definitely. It's like it feels more like the World of War zombies, like the first ones that came out. All dark and ominous, and, like, when you start out, you're just in a box. Like, on the map we played today, it's just, like, four windows, four people, that's it. And then you can go off and venture out, and it just feels like a more scary horror type of zombie thing than like the Black Ops 2 zombies was like an adventure kind of thing.
Right, it was more horror. It was like
horror type, we're trapped, we're gonna fucking die type of thing, you know?
Yeah, I mean, I've never played a zombie map where I had difficulty getting past round 10. It's a lot harder, that is like for certain. Like, it's just harder, the zombies are harder, and I feel like you get killed quicker. Because I remember getting trapped, and normally I would have like 5 to 6 seconds to get out of there. Now I have 3. I have literally 3 seconds to somehow find a hole and get out when I'm trapped.
Yeah, 100%. These zombies got fucking rapid fire on. They're fucking
swinging up. Rapid firing everything.
Just fucking flailing their arms everywhere. It beats my ass.
Come here! I was like, because when I thought, I was like, oh, I can take more than 2 hits. And then I was like, really, like, realized that means nothing. These zombies are quick, deadly, and scare the shit out of you. So. I think what I'm wondering is this can't be it though. Do you think that like that's it? Like now they're just gonna release DLC and is that gonna be it? Like just more maps, or are they gonna do more stuff with Black Ops 3? Now I'm like events or like bigger Easter eggs. Or, I don't know. What do you guys think?
I don't think so. You think it's because they opened it up to the community for modding and maps and everything, so.
They're just kind of like.
That's how I kind of see it.
That I'm excited for, but I really want them to make it like user friendly.
I think with the new DLC, it's gonna be like one map is just gonna be like it's just a fun map. Go ahead, play it. But I think the majority of it's gonna be all tied into the story, tied into past Call of Duties, all Easter egg type of things. Because they're taking more time on it, they're gonna do a better job with it. Like the DLC Zombie Master Black Ops 2 were really fucking good, and they. tied into a lot of different shit, and other ones were just for fun, kind of like the those one where you're on the ship and you got all the movie stars.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. The Call of the Dead.
Yeah, like that one was just a fun map. It was cool. You had superstars in there and stuff, but the other ones all tied into the lore, which are fucking dope. Which I think will do the same thing.
Call of the Dead was really cool. I like that.
Yeah, yeah, I like
Easter egg in that. I think if they made a story out of that, that would be amazing.
My question is okay, so right now, from what we know from, like, the Shadows of Evil, is that, here's what I think, there's two things. Either they're doing two different storylines, one where Maxis is, I guess, dead, and Richthofen isn't evil anymore, and they continue to, like, fight zombies, blah, blah, blah. Or now in Shadows of Evil, what I'm seeing is that, like, they're somehow tying in the campaign story with the Shadows of Evil. Like, I don't know if that makes sense, but, like, I feel like somehow the campaign is going to tie in with the Shadows of Evil storyline. Oh god, that's the monkey. No, run away! No, monkey's going to kill me. Monkey's going to kill me.
Like a zombies trailer, and it was like Richthofen going back in time and shit like that.
Yeah.
So
like the giant,
like the split timeline type of theory, you know? Like Richthofen did something and he split the alternate universes into two different timelines.
Yeah, so the story for the giant is they go back in time, they kill the evil Richthofen before he has a chance to like really start the entire zombie apocalypse, or I forgot what it was. Like, I don't know if before he locks her, it wasn't the giant, but before the events of the giant. Like, okay, so you don't remember Dereese, the last map for World at War? So yeah. It's back there, but just a different timeline. Or before
so,
it.
So, like, Notch Sterntoten.
Yeah, so it's basically, like, whatever was happening at the time of Dereese didn't happen. So it's before that. So I'm not sure if, like, Maxis and Samantha are dead now or what, but... There's continuing, and now I don't understand how they're going to tie it in with Shadows of Evil, because in Shadows of Evil, Maxis and Richthofen are not involved at all, so there's a new big bad guy, which is the aliens, or demons, or whatever the fuck they are. Because it's confusing, because there's these like demon alien squid things that are taking over.
And you can turn into them, which is fucking dope.
Yeah, you're just like, I am the beast! What do we call it, tentacle porn?
It's just like hentai now in Call of Duty with that.
No, hentai. So I'm just waiting to figure out both Easter eggs, compare them, and see if they're gonna do something like where Shadows of Evil was like Call of the Dead or Mob of the Dead, where it's just a separate storyline, and then the next DLC maps are just gonna be with the original cast. So I'm really excited to see that, and I'm excited to see what the storyline is. Who's the new big bad? Bad guy, you know, is it Maxis? Is it a new enemy we've never heard of? Like, I don't know. Like, there's so much to figure out.
People, man,
it's the tentacle porn people. I love how the monkey's blocking my exit. Like, I literally need to get out this way, but he's sitting there, like, nope, 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 nope. Don't run away from me. But anything else you guys want to add? Like, what are your favorite parts of Call of Duty's Black Ops 3 so far? Like, what is the...
Running on walls.
Right. The one
it's
little...
It's so satisfying when I'm running on a wall, and I take out a guy just, like, waiting for me. Like, he's waiting for me to get off the wall before he kills me, and I just pop him in the face.
You're like, nah,
it's
you're dead.
Great. Yeah, like, nah. I'm running on the wall, shooting me in the face, and I'm taking a picture of myself at the same time. It's called multitasking, all right?
That is amazing. What about the specialists? Like, how do they include that in... like competitive, because if you think about it, every specialist is super powerful.
Well, it's the same as fucking arena, man. Here's the thing: in competitive, you can choose whether to use the ban and protect system. If you choose to use it, then there's no specialists that are automatically banned. But if you do, there's a list of banned specialists. If you choose not to use the ban and protect, there's a list of specialists that are automatically banned. That would be Rejack, Psychosis, Kinetic Armor, Vision Pulse, and Hive. Those are automatically ban if you don't use the ban and protect system.
So basically, everything I use is gone.
Pretty much. So you better use the ban and protect system if you're going to play competitive.
I just want to know how they're going to do. Are they going to use Arena for like actual LAN events, or is this going to be predetermined?
No, it's just for. It's basically just like rank play. It's not. That's not what they're going to use for competitive.
I just want to see how like all the pro teams take this. It's so interesting how they take it when they go from a new game, especially with Black Ops 3, because it's honestly way different. There's so many new things in it, like the specialists, the wall running, the mechanics, the game modes. Everything is just so different. Like, it's not just a run and shoot. It's a run and shoot, look out for the big fucking, you know, dude with the flamethrower. And
yeah,
so
they're bringing
on
a lot of different, like, more strategy into this one, which I really
like. Yeah, like, fucking safeguard.
Okay, I have a question. How does safeguard exactly work? Because from when I was playing it, it was basically whoever was escorting the robot pretty much won the round.
No, not necessarily. Basically, you have to escort the robot to the other team's base. And you can do that. I mean, you just have to stand by it. But the other team can disable your robot, so then so you have to reboot it, and it slows down the process by about a minute. So literally, if you want to win that game mode, though, use the Annihilator, because it's 4 shots of the Annihilator to take down the whole robot, which is actually really fucking good.
So there was like a time to beat. How does that work?
That's in the overtime, so basically, if you get the robot to the other team's base, the other team has to beat that time, but if you don't, the other team just has to get the robot to the other team's base.
Okay,
it's
gotcha.
Time limit. Yeah. Yeah, that happened to us. That's why.
I was just so confused. I was like, wait, what is this? What is this? Like, we can't destroy the robot, but we can beat times. I don't know. I didn't even know how I won that game. I was like, oh, wait, we won. Cool. What?
Yeah.
Wait, what? I wonder if they would ever do
it's
anything.
It's really strategic.
It's just one of those games that's going to be, like, live forever kind of thing. Well, at least for a really long time.
Safeguard's really fun.
What do you think about fucking crawler? Oh god, there's crawlers everywhere. So you know how with the campaign you've got like the nightmare campaign. You think they would add missions onto that, like in DLC?
No, I don't think so.
It'd be cool if they did.
It'd be cool.
I think they might tie like zombie maps in the DLC or missions in the DLC that go along with it, but I don't.
Well, they've already finished the DLC.
Necessary.
DLC is already finished. They finish that stuff pretty much when the game comes out.
I just feel like Vondahar is just like laughing. I have so many secrets and you'll never know. And we're all like, God damn it. I have one complaint though about paint job. Like the paint jobs.
Yeah.
They don't cover enough of the gun.
I hate that.
They cover up like a small section of the gun and you have to make a paint job that fits whatever camo you're using. And I'm like, fuck this!
I can't do my Hello Kitty paint job.
I know, right? I can't do my epic wolf, like wolf zombie paint job because it doesn't fit the damn gun. I'm just like, you know what? Screw this. I'm gonna go kill some zombies. Oh, God. And then... ooh, nuke.
Yay!
Okay. Everyone's getting quiet, so I'm just like, what to talk about next?
I'm doing the campaign right now.
It's like, lol. So what's the least favorite thing about Black Ops 3 for you guys?
My least favorite thing about it is probably, I don't know.
It's like, nothing. I don't know.
I just, for some reason, I don't like the feel of Hardpoint anymore. Does anyone else feel that way?
No, I like Hardpoint. The thing that I don't like about it isn't the game itself. It's the community. It's the way people play. It's just like a lot of sitting in corners, waiting for someone else. You get the kill. There you go.
Yeah,
like,
so basically
that's
camping.
How I learned to play.
I'm going to sit in this corner of my Tempest and just fucking charge it up and shock people to death. It's fucking bullshit. It pisses me off. And the landmines and shit, like...
I mean, that's the whole reason they added the vertical aspect, so you can't... You shouldn't be doing that.
Shouldn't be, but, I mean, people still do. You shouldn't be throwing C4, but people still do.
Wait, there's C4? They brought it back?
Yes.
Yeah, there's C4, and it's AIDS.
I don't remember...
It's delicious.
I don't know, I haven't seen anyone use it yet.
Yeah, because people fucking ban it in Arena for some reason. I don't know why. It's a waste of a ban.
Is there a certain amount of bans you can have?
Yeah, each player can ban or protect one thing.
Oh, okay. I would immediately protect freaking War Machine. It's like, no! I'm keeping this shit, it's fun! That's another thing. I've yet to see the War Machine in Zombies. I want to see it in Zombies. This is good now. Like, the War Machine used to be horrible. Now it's fun, and you know, you can destroy zombies with it, but I don't know. It
blows me the fuck up, dude.
It literally blows you. Literally.
Whee!
One thing I want to see added, though, is a fix to, like, the PS4 ports. I doubt they're ever going to do it, but I'd like to see that. Because it's just like... Not, like, you just can't use controllers. And then also, like, the split screen on PC is kind of broken.
You don't have two controllers, so...
No, you should be able to use them. It's on PC. You should be able to use, like, PS4 and keyboard combined. But it's...
Yeah. But... Maybe they just thought people would have two controllers laying around.
I mean, yeah,
I have,
but...
like, three, and I don't even have a console. So...
I sold all mine. It's like, I'm playing on PC, I want
Xbox controller.
Roasted.
Run away. This is another thing, it's like, I hope... Oh, God, hi. Giant oxen trying to run me over. No, stay away from me. There's one thing I was trying to think about. It's like, when Fallout 4 comes out, how am I going to decide what to play? Because I want to play both of them, but they both take up so much time.
There's no deciding. It's Fallout 4.
Dude, who's getting the Division Black... and Rainbow Six Sage?
Did you just call it Sage?
Yeah. It's pronounced Siege, but yeah, I'm getting that.
I call it Sage.
It's not Sage.
Oh, yeah, I'm getting that too. I'm getting Siege... Fallout 4. I'm not getting,
getting the... Just Cause 3.
You should get the Division next year, man, when it comes out.
Oh, I thought it came out this year.
No, it comes out next year. It got pushed back, and it pissed me off.
Oh, I'll get that. Seems fun.
Yeah. I think it's in, like, February. It comes out in, like, February.
Fallout 4 is gonna have so much shit, and then I'm just like, ooh, Fallout 4, cool! And then I was like, oh, wait, Black Ops 3. Oh, wait, Rainbow Six. Ah! So many games. So little time. I just don't know how to split it up. I just want to play zombies.
Just don't go to sleep.
You know how that... Have you seen how that works out for me recently? Not very good.
It worked great.
Last time I tried that, no sleep?
Fantastic.
I missed the date for the podcast, the time for the podcast. I was just like... Oh, it's 2:30. I just woke up. Great. I thought no one was coming on, so I was just like, okay, I'm going to go, play some games and record some videos, and then Hydra's like, hey, you going to do the podcast? I was like, oh, great. Okay, we'll do it.
He's pushing you to do your own podcast.
I'm sorry, I just got kind of lazy today. Oh my god. Stay away from me, zombies. No! Holy shit. So Dead Ops Arcade just got a lot more interesting. You can basically upgrade your guns, which is amazing.
Dude, I'm still fucking doing this right now. Still working on this campaign. I'm still.
It's gonna take you a while.
Yeah.
What difficulty are you playing it on?
I don't even know, man.
Recruit.
No, I don't know. Hold on, let me check.
I don't know, man.
I think I can check, can I?
I think if you do change difficulty, like whatever difficulty is less.
I'm on hard right now.
It's not too bad.
I'm just gonna change it to recruit.
I just want to get through this quickly.
He dies more.
Dude, I died a couple times.
Yeah.
And you call yourself a professional Call of Duty player.
Bruh, I ain't no pro. I just do it for fun.
Oh man, you gotta go pro. If you don't go pro, it's not worth it. You're just a noob.
No, that's like 10-year-old talking.
I know. That's another thing. I've never. It's. Just me, is there an infestation of just annoying people playing COD?
Yeah, it seems like it.
It's like. What? All you people.
Bruh. Dude, I love fucking free run. Who else?
Maps aren't really that fun. Once you beat them, they're just kind of like.
Eh. Dude, you know what? I like going against my friends in that. It's fucking amazing. Me and Joey just sit there and face off against each other, and we'll always, like, fucking go, we'll beat each other by, like, fucking 10 seconds. Except for one, and it was the last one, and he beat me by, he got everything on, he got one fault, my bad. And so he had, like, 2 minutes and 35 seconds, and I just couldn't do it.
Okay. I've got boxing gloves right now, and this is absolutely amazing.
Bro, who cares about your boxing gloves?
Apparently the zombies, because they keep getting kapowed. Absolutely amazing. I played Free Run, and it was fun, but once I beat the maps, I was like, eh, okay.
Well, you can't beat the maps, dude.
Once, you know, like, I completed them with a time.
So oh.
I was like, eh, okay, now what? But now I think I'm going to go play against Fabio and kick his ass.
No.
Bro, I got to kill these robots? What the fuck?
Fabio's just shaking and said, no. No, yeah, Fabio, you're gonna get your ass handed to you Free Run. It's on right after this podcast. It is on.
In what, multiplayer?
Free Run.
Oh, I don't. I like played it once. I don't even know.
It was really disappointing. Oh.
Like oh,
fuck
I get
Free Run.
Free Run. How do you jump again?
Space. Press space. Okay. Okay, I'm done. They've included little Easter eggs in Dead Ops Arcade that links to zombies. Like, the Shadows of Evil. What the fuck? Can they stop messing with my mind? I don't get it. They're just like, hey, look, let's include this. Screw with everyone again. But, well, getting about that time, any final words from, you guys, anything else you guys want to include? Say, opinions, hopes, dreams?
Bro, are we done already?
It's been 2 hours.
Bro, it's been five.
It has not been 2 hours. It's been like fucking half an hour.
Actually, it's been five.
It's been an hour.
It's been like half an hour, bitch.
Actually, it's been five.
That's 50 minutes, like right there.
I know, it's like... Are you serious? But yeah, anything else you guys want to say before we end?
Buddha is Garbo at BO3.
I think he admitted that at the beginning.
I'm gonna beat the fucking shit out of you, Hydra.
Make sure to record it.
Bruh, I'm just fucking...
We meet in person, dude. You're cashing the hands, 100%.
Dude, I will fight you, bro.
This is nice, bro.
I want
nice on the sticks. I'm nice in real life. Ooh. Fight you 100%.
Nice on the
this
sticks.
Guy's a terrible driver.
Oh.
Settle it in Smash.
Dude, I remember how they fucking they hold tournaments for Smash at school.
Shit's insane.
Dude, it fucking
those guys are too good.
Way too fucking competitive.
My college has something like that. It's insane.
It's just competitive enough. It's fucking insane. Those guys go ham.
They're just like, oh, you want to try it out? Yeah, I die in like 2 seconds.
Yeah, right. I just get fucking comboed. I'm like, I don't know what to do.
Smash Bros. There's a reason I don't play that game anymore. I've lost too many friends to that game.
But I made it to semifinals in the COD tourney, and I lost by one fucking point. I was so mad.
It's because you suck.
Bruh, you suck. I could beat you by 20.
Probably, but you still suck.
1 point is not sucking, bruh.
Yeah, it is. That is sucking because you should have had more than 1 point on him. But no, Hydro fails us. Fails us. He can't even... Man, you should have had that shit. No, you lost to a kid at your school. I can't take it, man.
That kid has made you his bitch, dude.
Yeah.
Beat you by one. If it was a blowout, all right, okay, you're just better. But he beat you by one, you're close.
But dude, we did a 2-hour practice before the tournament, and I beat everyone. No one beat me in practice. That's the weird part. I was so mad. I remember we played Arcane 1v1. Like, it was a 1v1.
Play Claw in practice.
I can't play Claw. It's
fucks up my fingers.
I know. Plus, whenever I touch whenever I touch a controller, I'm just like, this feels so weird.
Lucky guy.
Oh my god, I've beat my high score of round 16. Shadow Boogie. Oh no, this is actually where I died last time. I don't know what the fuck to think of this. Oh my god, it's the dude from Campaign! Fuck! They've linked Campaign now?! Stop driving me insane, game.
They're all intertwined.
Everything's intertwined like a game should be. What the fuck, Call of Duty?
My final words is follow me on Twitter, your boy. Don't forget that.
Yeah, so make sure to follow everyone on Twitter. Last thing I wanted to say. Hydro for horrible Call of Duty content. Buddha for
some horrible content, but I may say something funny every now and again, so that's cool.
Buddha for that interesting word that you never would have thought to he would have said.
Guys, call in that 1-800 Buddha sucks, and then type 1 for Buddha sucks.
That's not a valid phone number.
Type 2 for Wolfie's better.
Buddha sucks. That's too many digits.
No, it's a special phone.
Yeah, it's that rotary phone.
You gotta text it.
It's a rotary
text
phone.
Text 1-800 Buddha. Why? Tank, give me the tank. Yeah, I'm in the tank.
Press 1 for Buddha sucks. Press 2 for Wolfie's better than Buddha.
I thought this was a podcast on Black Ops 3, not shit on Buddha. Right?
Real shit on Buddha.
It's shit on Buddha night.
Oh my god.
Take a whole night and shit on Buddha.
Literally or figuratively?
Both.
Oh.
Damn, he's gonna be a little bit too brown in the morning.
But yeah, so make sure to follow Buddha for wise words. Follow Hydro for confusing Call of Duty content. Follow Favio for good audio and video quality. Follow me for just random shit that doesn't make sense. And
follow me for retweets.
Hydro for retweeting. All right, thank you.
Buddha, you need to shut the fuck up before I shit on you.
You two need to face off, and I just like seriously.
I'm recording that. We're gonna get that big blow up like ring with the big ass fucking sticks with the foam ends on it and beat the shit out of them.
Boom!
What's up, bit?
At the next LAN event, just
do the sumo thing where you have the sumo thing.
Down, dude.
Alright, guys. Well, thank you all for coming out to the podcast tonight. Again, you guys, tweet us if you guys have any questions for next week's podcast. Next week, we'll probably be talking about something different since we've been on a bit of a BO3 thing. Really? Streak here.
Didn't notice.
Yeah. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for stopping by the stream. And until next time, make sure to love yourselves and love life. Make sure to follow these guys. And don't follow them. Don't. They're horrible.